what happened last night at the Royal Rumble? It was a fluke! I was not supposed to lose the WWE title to John Cena! But you see, in the course of history, in the course of WWE history, it's not gonna be remembered. No. See, I'm not gonna wait until WrestleMania. I'm not gonna wait until Saturday night's main event. Because I'm gonna invoke my rematch clause for the WWE Championship tonight! I'm not gonna be a transitional champion! And John, I'm gonna beat you to within an inch of your life. I'm gonna take back what's rightfully mine. So spin it up nice, shine it up nice. Because I'm taking back what's rightfully mine. I'm taking back the WWE Championship!
3 weeks ago, at New Year's Revolution, John Cena survived the brutal Elimination Chamber matchup and retained the WWE Championship.
Yes, it did. But then in one of the brilliant moves of all time, King, Edge cashed in the Money in the Bank opportunity 10 months after winning it at WrestleMania. Oh, baby, Edge took out John Cena and became the WWE Champion.
Yes, he did. Two spears and a pin, and John Cena became the X-Champ. And Edge became the Rated R Superstar.
And perhaps the most opportunistic WWE Champion we've ever had. But then last night at the Royal Rumble, remember, John Cena said, hey, hats off to you, Edge. You cashed in your opportunity, but I want my rematch.
Boy, and as you can see, John Cena had his hands on Lita, but then moved out of the way and let Edge do the damage. Knocked Lita right off the ring. And then Edge turned around right into the F.U. from John Cena. And Edge became what he was termed his worst nightmare, a transitional champion. John Cena, once again, the champion here. And tonight, as I said, it's unprecedented. The main event from the Royal Rumble is going to be a rematch right here tonight. The WWE Championship on the line.
And the championship will change hands again. Oh. Say that, King.
Okay.
You know what's going
to
happen.
Edge trying to take the title from John Cena tonight. Oh, Edge putting his hands on the referee. You don't want to get disqualified.
No, he's just making sure he knew.
No!
Face first into the top turnbuckle goes Edge.
Look out. There goes Edge.
Sit out, double it back. Cover bomb.
Coach, here we go.
I don't want to see the five knuckle shuffle.
Well, you don't have to see it because Edge can't see me either. Go ahead, Joey, call it. Five knuckle shuffle, a kiss blown to Lita.
And right between the eyes.
Edge is going to teach John Cena a lesson about being cocky.
He's pumping it up.
He's Cena pumping it up. He's got Edge up for the FU. Edge is fighting it.
Whoa.
Oh, my gosh.
And down goes the referee. And in desperation, Edge just shoves John Cena forward, and John Cena ran right through the referee.
And John Cena was counting his chickens before they hatched.
And I think Edge intentionally shoved Cena into the ref, and now
that was definitely intentional.
You're right.
There was that definitely intentional, no question there, King. A blatant low blow by Edge.
Hey, the referee has not seen a thing.
Well, this is desperation.
He can't call what he can't see, and right now, John Cena can't see Edge. Oh, there's a spear!
There's a spear on the cover, yes. Covered by Edge!
Come on, Mickey, it's
the referee.
Get your ass
off. The referee is still down.
Get off!
Well, it's Edge's fault the referee is down.
What is Lita doing? She's gonna try to take the title? Oh, wait, Edge's asking for the championship belt? Look out, look out!
If you go!
Hey, what happened? She used the belt. Disqualification.
The referee saw Lita.
What did he say?
Here is your winner by disqualification, Edge.
The referee has disqualified Edge. He saw Lita use the belt on John Cena. Oh, my God. Edge's hopes and dreams just went up in smoke thanks to Lita's interference. Well, yeah, he wins the match.
I think there's disbelief all the way around.
Wait a minute.
By Edge, by John Cena.
Hold it, wait a minute. Who got disqualified?
Well, Edge won the match. John Cena can't believe that.
Well, I'm confused here.
Well, it depends who Lita hit with that championship belt in front of the referee.
I don't think Lita knows what's going on either.
Wait a minute, can we see that again? We gotta sort this out. I think Lita, let's see what she's doing here.
She hit out!
She and Edge went to head for the championship belt in front of the referee.
That's what the referee saw. She saw Lita hit Edge, and the referee went disqualified Cena.
But Edge won the match.
Why did she do it? Why did Lita do that?
What does this mean? We gotta find out. Amazing.
What the hell's going on?
Edge, last week Lita blasted you with the WWE Championship. So I was wondering why did
Shut up. First of all, I am pleased to announce that live, right here next week on Raw, there's going to be a huge match. A huge match for the WWE Championship. It'll be your current and undeserving champion, John Cena. Versus the Rated R Superstar himself, me.
That's huge.
And you may ask, why do I get a rematch?
I'll ask.
It's simple. Last week, I beat John Cena.
Just like I said that Edge was going to do.
Well, technically.
I beat him by disqualification, and boo all you want. But that goes down in the record books as a victory for me. And that means I get a rematch. Now, that disqualification happened when Lita hit me in the head with the WWE title. And that's been the burning question all week. Everybody's been, Rated R, Rated R, what's going on with Lita? Some people think maybe Lita had a change of heart. Maybe she's sick of the old Edgemeister. Maybe she has deep-rooted feelings for John Cena.
I doubt that.
Or maybe Lita saw that I was in the FU and came in and intentionally cost Cena the match. But really, the only person who can answer this question is Lita herself. So baby, why'd you do it? I don't think so. You see, I'm always four moves ahead of you dumbasses. Oh. Lita isn't the issue. The issue is me beating John Cena for the WWE Championship. And when I do, my championship reign, the most watched championship reign in over 4 years, continues. And that means that the winner of the Road to WrestleMania tournament will face me. And Maria, oh, sweet little Maria. That also means that when you announce me, when you introduce me, you don't get that stupid little smile on your face. You don't bat your pretty green little eyes. And you don't call me the former WWE champion. You got that, Toots?
But you should be happy to be a former WWE champion.
Look, babe, I got this one, okay?
Hey. Oh, boy.
Listen, dummy, I'm gonna make this really easy for you, okay? You take that little microphone of yours and those pretty little lips and you announce, my man, not as the former WWE Champion, but the future WWE Champion. You got it?
the future WWE Champion, Edge.
That's got a nice ring to it, it really does.
I'm gonna give you 2 seconds.
Take it easy, tough guy. Take it easy.
That's Hacksaw.
You know, I heard Vince McMahon was looking for a special guest referee for that big title match next week with John Cena.
Uh-oh.
And I figure, who better to call it straight down the middle than Hacksaw Jim Duggan?
That's a good idea.
Wait a minute. Who
no
better?
Way.
Who better? What the hell are you talking about? Who better?
USA!
Shut up!
What the hell does the USA have to do with this? What the hell are you doing? Listen, for the past few weeks, you've been trying to make my girlfriend's life a living hell, and you want to be the guest referee? Well, I don't think so.
Why? Because I call her.
Whoa! Don't do it.
Don't go.
All I did was call her.
Hey, wait, I'm warning you. I'm warning you.
Yeah.
Okay, don't worry. I won't say nothing. On second thought, leaders are
Well, Hacksaw is...
Oh, God!
I don't hear Hacksaw saying anything now. Maybe a little...
Oh. Now, wait a minute. What's Lita doing pointing at Maria?
Well, Maria was laughing.
Maria,
you need
to get... Everyone was laughing. Maria needs to get out of there. That was funny. You know it was funny.
Oh, come on!
That's funny.
That's not funny.
Look at
it!
Good grief! She pulled her hair off by the roots!
Oh, no, wait a minute. Oh. What is...
No.
He's in position for the spear!
Here we go! Look at this!
The WWE Champion John Cena's here! Thank heaven!
Oh, come on back here now!
Jim Duggan's board. I need to hear this from you. Next week there's going to be a special guest referee.
Oh yeah, it's a championship match. Why not have a special guest referee?
Okay, fine. Well then, I think the special guest referee should be Lita.
Lita?
Yeah. What do you think? Isn't that great?
Don't you think she might be just a little bit biased in your favor?
Look, Mr. McMahon, isn't there anything I can do so you could see things our way? I'd really love to ref that special match.
Let me get this straight. You're standing there and you're encouraging your girlfriend to come on to... I find this repugnant. I find it repulsive. What the hell kind of a man are you? You'd pimp out your own girlfriend just to gain a favor like this, an advantage in a championship match? You know what? I find qualities like that to be admirable, actually. I mean, when you think about it, I mean, it means that you would do anything to win the WWE Championship.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. You know, but I'm going to allow you the opportunity to perhaps name Lita, because I'm going to put the two of you in a match tonight. The winner of this match will name the guest referee in the championship match next week. So it'll be then tonight, here in Atlanta, it'll be you two in a mixed tag team matchup. You and Lita against, let's see, Maria and the champ, John Cena.
Oh, wow.
Oh, Oh, now, wait a minute. What's Lita doing here?
I don't know, but John Cena sees Lita.
Look out, look out!
And once again, Lita proves to be the distraction.
And once again, John Cena proves that he isn't that smart. Go ahead! And Lita is the legal competitor.
A Lita Conrada on Edge. John Cena with the sidestep.
So Lita,
wait a second.
It just hit her.
Lita is the legal person. Don't do it, Cena. You can't put your hands on her.
He can't put his hands on her.
It's a mixed tag. It's not an intergender match.
What is Lita? She's begging, pleading, or what is she saying?
Oh, my gosh! Oh. She's flashing! Look out! And John Cena with another sidestep. Lita gets speared.
Oh, my.
Edge thrown to the outside, and Maria just blind tagged herself in.
Oh, wait.
She's talking to Lita.
Look at this!
Who do you think John Cena's going to name his special ref?
Oh, baby. We just won, which means I get to pick the special guest referee for the championship match next week.
Too bad, Edge.
Just so happens I found somebody. They were in town today, saw him in the back, and I didn't want to be confident or nothing, but I already asked, and they accepted. So, I ain't gonna make nobody wait. I'm gonna let you know who it is right now.
Who is it?
This is huge.
This is the perfect person, just in case next week the Rated R Superstar is feeling a little hardcore.
Uh-oh, what? Hardcore?
Special guest referee for next week's WWE Championship match between John Cena and Edge.
Look at Edge. I think he's screwed. Well, I don't know how Edge is supposed to get a fair shake, but next week, it indeed is going to happen.
We are making big time. Can you see me winking at
Hey.
Hey,
what are you doing?
You got some pipes on your Mac, huh?
A little something I worked on in the shower.
You know, this is so cute. I was just noticing that.
I appreciate that.
And I was also noticing, I think you lost a little weight.
You think so?
Yeah.
No. You know what it is? Vertical stripes, they create that slimming feeling.
Stop.
It's intentional.
You're being modest. And you know what else you've got?
What?
Brains.
You think?
Oh, yeah. Some of those books, and especially Scooter.
Did you read Scooter?
Pretty awesome, yeah.
What was your favorite part?
My favorite part was, was when Scooter and his friend were gonna...
Okay, cut the crap. Nobody read your book, okay? I came here because I've come too far to get screwed over by you in this match with Cena. Wait. Is this what this is all about? You think I'm gonna screw you? First of all, Edge, you and I go way back. Farther than me and John Cena, that's for sure. And second of all, I still remember when I was special guest referee at WrestleMania 15. Making the count that crowned Austin the new champion over The Rock, it's still one of the highlights of my career. So, you saying you want to see me beat Cena for the title tonight then, right? No. Oh, hell no. You see, Edge, I think the way you've been acting lately has been disgusting. And besides, I happen to be a huge Hacksaw Jim Duggan fan. Where do you think I got the thumbs up? Ho! All kidding aside, you put Cena on the deck fair and square, I've got no problem. Counting the 1, 2, 3. All right, Mick. Because if you don't, it'll be the biggest mistake you've ever made. You understand? Have a nice day.
At a very opportunistic time, cashed in his money in the bank.
He got him! My God, what has happened here tonight?
And he beat me for the WWE Championship.
Whether you like it or not, I stand before you, your new WWE Champion.
John Cena wants his WWE Championship back. He wants it back here tonight at the Royal Rumble. John Cena with everything he's got hammering the WWE Champion.
Is that going to be a transitional champion? Look out, he's going to tap!
What happened last night at the Royal Rumble? It was a fluke.
John Cena has done it! John Cena has regained the championship!
I was not supposed to lose, so I'm going to invoke my rematch clause for the WWE Championship tonight.
It's unprecedented. It's unbelievable. Edge invoking his rematch clause less than 24 hours after losing the WWE Championship to John Cena last night at the Royal Rumble.
I'm taking back what's rightfully mine.
Edge knows what he's doing. He's got a plan.
Wait a minute, who got disqualified?
Edge, last week Lita blasted you with the WWE Championship.
She hit Edge!
Why did Lita do that?
So I was wondering why did
Shut up. Last week I beat John Cena. I beat him by disqualification, and that means I get a rematch. I am pleased to announce that live, right here next week on Raw, it'll be your current an undeserving champion, John Cena, versus the rated R superstar himself, me.
I'm gonna put the two of you in a match tonight. The winner of this match will name the guest referee in the championship match next week. So it'll be you two in a mixed tag team matchup against Maria and the champ, John Cena.
That is a huge spoil that will go to the victor of this matchup. John Cena sees Lita. And once again, Lita proved to be the distraction. A Lita Khan run on Edge. John Cena with the sidestep.
What is Lita? She's begging?
Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
Lita gets speared. Edge spurred to the outside, and Maria just blind tagged herself in.
Look at this!
Who do you think John Cena's going to name as special ref?
This is the perfect person, just in case next week the rated R superstar is feeling a little hardcore. Mick Foley!
Former three-time WWE Champion Mick Foley, a special guest referee.
And indeed is going to happen. John Cena and Edge, the WWE Championship is on the line.
Look at Edge! I think he's screwed!
I can't believe John Cena has enough to pump it up.
Here it comes, the FU. Cena's going for the FU.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah. DDT. Mick, get down. Cover.
Cover. Could be it.
And three low.
Oh, man. The left shoulder just barely got up off the canvas.
Damn it. Foley screwed Edge right there.
No.
The hell he didn't. You're watching the same match that I am.
Spear!
No! Edge puts the brakes on! Here we go, the FU! No!
No!
Edge just shoves Cena into referee Mick Foley! Then nails Foley! Was that accidental?
Dropped home!
Oh, by Cena!
Here we go!
Here it is, the STFU! He's got it locked in! Cena's got the STFU on Edge! Edge is tapping!
Mick Foley can't see.
Well, right now, John Cena sees Lita. She was all the way out.
And again, Lita provides the distraction for Edge.
Now where's she going?
She's coming over here right by us. I can tell.
Oh, no, wait a minute. She's got the WWE Championship belt.
Edge, make it quick.
Watch it, Cena. Watch it.
Make it quick. Right to the skull of Cena.
He cannot win it this way.
Lita, go get Mick. Go tell Mick.
Edge is on top of Cena, but Mick Foley's on the outside.
There you go.
Mick Foley was out of position, but it was Edge's fault.
Cover him, Edge.
Cover, there it is. Two.
No.
Cena gets the shoulder up.
What does Edge have to do to reach the top of the mountain again?
Well, he's climbing to the top now.
deliver the final blow. Here it comes. Oh, no, he's
Drake by Cena!
Are you kidding me?
Unbelievable!
You cover!
Wow!
Cena wins! Cena wins!
What an amazing turn of events! Edge just got screwed tonight by Mick Foley! You saw it!
Oh, come on!
I saw it! Everybody in Greensboro saw it!
What match were you watching, Coach? You've got to give the champ the props right there.
You cost me! You son of a bitch!
Foley just got what he deserved. I couldn't have said any better myself. Edge just said, you cost me, Mick Foley. And that's indeed what Mick Foley did.
Edge speared Mick Foley after the low blow from Lita.
Cena's taking the WWE Championship to WrestleMania, but look at Mick.
We'll find out who he's going to face next week.
You think you know me?
That is too hot for
On this day,
watch it, Chris.
Oh, there he is. The rated R superstar. And he's talking about somebody that I can't
realize there he is, but what's he doing out here now?
Does it matter? He's the man.
Yeah, but Candace wasn't finished, and I wasn't finished looking at Candace.
Well, I think Edge was finished listening to Candace.
Oh, look out, Candace.
You want to talk about being champion? Well, I should be champion. So get the hell out of my ring, toots, right now. Voices like damn nails on a chalkboard. Hit the bricks, toots. Now to the issue at hand. You see, last week, I had John Cena beat. And the only reason I'm not standing here as champion is because of one man. And that one man's name is Mick Foley. So Mick, I hope you're sitting at home nice and comfy in your couch. I hope you're watching real close, because I'm going to give you a personal lesson on what happens when you mess with the rated R superstar. You see, for the past few weeks, I've had a bunch of nobodies, a bunch of idiots like all of you. Come up to me with your best Hacksaw Jim Duggan impersonation. Yeah, just like that, calling my girlfriend a hoe. Well, you see, tonight I take care of that, because I challenged Hacksaw Jim Duggan to a match and he accepted.
Whoa. Doing the Hacksaw impersonation
very
now.
Very funny. Hacksaw, you get your wall-eyed, goofy butt down here right now, because you're going to find out what happens when you mess with my man, the Rated R Superstar. Come on.
No one ever said Doug was the smartest guy. Why would you accept the match against Edge? I wasn't saying anything.
Gets planted, the Hacksaw get ready to get in a three-point stance. I can assure you this is not going the way Edge had expected. Hey, wait a minute, look at this.
Watch it.
Yeah.
have the guts to face Edge again, that's gonna happen one more time. Edge making an example out of Hacksaw Jim Duggan here tonight, and I love it.
Oh, wait a minute.
No, wait a minute.
Oh my God.
I bet that hurt.
Oh, look at this.
Well, Edge.
Yeah, let's see, Coach. You got the smile. Lita's got the smile. Edge has got the smile. Everything's going your way.
Yeah, man, it's been a good night so far.
Foley, did you see that? Did you see what I did to Duggan? And he didn't do anything like you did to me. You cost me my dream of walking into WrestleMania as the champion. You son of a bitch!
Oh, come on.
So I'm gonna make it real simple, because I know you only got one ear. And Mick, I'm gonna give you 1 week to accept my challenge in this ring. And if you don't come here, I'm gonna come to Long Island, drag your sorry carcass into your backyard, and beat the hell out of you in front of your entire family.
And I guarantee you, Edge will do that. So if I'm Mick Foley, I better show up next week in Washington, D.C. How ironic.
Oh,
we're in the nation's capital.
You can't guarantee a damn thing except that you're going to talk to somebody. That's the only thing you can guarantee. Look at this. Sick. And you think that Mick Foley wouldn't show up to accept the challenge, Coach?
All I know is that Mick Foley indeed did end Edge's dream of main eventing at WrestleMania. And Mick Foley, if he does accept, is going to pay, and pay big time.
How can you blame Mick Foley? He called it right down the middle as he said he would.
You know, actually, you know, I don't want him to show up.
Come on, look, let's check this out one more time. Look at Lita. She is always involved some sort of way. Provided the distraction, and then Edge gets the spear and the 1-2-3. And then after the match, look at this, Billy.
This is just a horrible, a low blow with a 2x4 to Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
It depends which way you look at it, but I, you know, personally, I'd love to see the backyard beating, too.
I'd love to see these two get a room. Come on.
Time's up, Mick Foley. It's been a week since I challenged you. You and me, Edge and Foley at WrestleMania. So what is it? What is it? Yes or no? You see, I don't know what you got planned for April 2nd. I don't know if you're gonna whore yourself out at another indie show.
Man.
Whether you're going to start writing another book that nobody's going to read.
Come on.
But surely this has to be your best option.
Let's get an
answer. So what's it going to be, Mick? What is it going to be?
I told you, he's not showing up.
Just like I thought, baby. Baby, you can get the tickets out.
Tickets?
You see, what Lita is holding in her hand is 2 plane tickets to Long Island. And Mick, we can be there by midnight. And I'll do it because I should be main eventing at WrestleMania, and it's your fault that I'm not.
Let's go to Foley's house.
So Mick, if you're not man enough to show up, then it looks like Lita and I are gonna have to make ourselves a little house call.
I hope they take a camera. I'd like to.
Edge. You see, you've got it all wrong. It's not that I'm not man enough to come all the way to Washington, D.C.
Obligatory cheap pop.
It's just that it's not the point. You see, it was you that lost to John Cena at the Royal Rumble. It was you that lost to John Cena 2 weeks ago on Raw. So if you're looking for somebody to blame, Edge, don't blame me. Blame yourself. Because you had it, and you choked.
You didn't choke.
No, no, no. The only choking that's going to happen is my hands on your throat at WrestleMania 22. So what is it? Yes or no? Yes or no, Foley?
No.
No?
You see, a while back, Edge, you called me a transitional champion, but it just so happens that I was a transitional champion on 3 separate occasions. Therefore, making me the greatest transitional champion of all time.
3-time transitional champion.
So I'm saying no because I have nothing to prove to you.
You have nothing to prove. Oh, that's right, because you're the great Mick Foley. Well, shut up. Well, if I'm the Rated R superstar, then you're Rated O. Rated O for overrated. You see, Mick, you're not going to be remembered for your 3 title wins. Oh, you'll be remembered for 3 things. Number one, having your ear ripped off. Number two, being thrown off the Hell in a Cell. And number three, showing up in Vince McMahon's hospital room with a damn sock puppet.
That was good.
Mick, you're pathetic. And Mick, you do have a lot to prove. Because you've never won at WrestleMania.
Well, that's not true, Edge.
Oh, it is true. Oh, technically, you've had your countouts and your disqualifications and your dumpster matches that nobody even remembers. But, you've never had that classic, defining, legend-making WrestleMania performance that you crave. Yeah, it's true, folks. But me, the Rated R superstar, I've never lost at WrestleMania. Oh yeah, triangle ladder matches, TLC matches, Money in the Bank ladder matches. I won in my hometown of Toronto. But that's okay, Mick, I get it now. Tuck your tail between your legs. Because you know if you fought me at WrestleMania, you'd lose.
You're right. If I had a wrestling match with you at WrestleMania, I would lose. You're younger, you're in better shape, and apparently you care a whole hell of a lot more about me than I do about you. But you're right. In my career, I never had that one defining WrestleMania moment. Deep down, I've known it, and deep down, I've needed it for a long time. So while I reject your offer for a wrestling match at WrestleMania, I'd like to challenge you to another match.
Uh-oh.
Where there are no rules.
Uh-oh.
There are no disqualifications, and there are no excuses.
No, wait a second.
Come on, Edge. What's it gonna be? Yes or no? Well, I'll tell you what. Just in case you need to make up your mind, I'm gonna give you a little bit of help.
A little bit of help. Now what? Where's Foley going? Probably back to Long Island.
Look at Edge. He doesn't know what to think. Should he accept it?
Oh, no.
That's hardcore. That's what it's all about. A baseball bat wrapped in barbed wire. Hey, and he's going to get out to the ring. Look out.
And as we've seen, that barbed wire.
Don't try to hide behind us. Look at Edge and Lita. They're having to make their exit through these fans.
I don't blame them.
Why shouldn't you? Because, like you said, it's a mismatch.
And Lita
is not in Lita's class yet.
Lita felt humiliated by being pinned by Maria. Now she wants to humiliate Maria.
Listen to this crowd, coach.
I can hear them.
I think Lita's going to make the cover of a magazine. Who magazine?
Who? Fitness, while I have a second to recap what we saw earlier tonight. And King, have you ever seen somebody look that good on the camera? I never have. Anybody. I'm not talking anybody at any age has never looked better than Mr. McMahon does on the cover of Muscle Fitness.
Boy, I just want to be there when Coach has had his lip surgically removed from Mr. McMahon's
and
area.
What about Candace? I can't hear you guys. I'm going to call my own show. What about Candace on the cover of Playboy?
Yeah, hot.
That's the best cover I've ever seen of that, too.
Well, let's try to concentrate on this match.
Maria tried to land a clothesline. Lita saw it coming a mile away. Oh, my God. And Maria just gets smite.
Come on.
Hey, King, what match were you talking about?
Cover. Mercifully, this is over.
I was talking about this match.
Is over.
Here is your winner, Lita.
I want to ask, what did that prove? What did that prove?
Well, it's great to see Lita back on the winning track.
Oh, okay.
It proved to me that Maria better stick with the kiss cam.
Why is Edge taking his jacket off?
I don't know, but...
Oh, no, wait a minute. Come on, wait a minute. Hey, Rip.
Oh, no.
He's going to spear Maria.
No, don't do that.
Hey, Edge, turn around. Hey!
It's Mick Foley.
Turn around, come on. What the hell is Mick Foley doing here tonight?
What do you mean? Mick Foley has arrived just in the nick of time. We got to watch your back. Watch your back, Mick.
Lead all over Mick Foley.
Oh, spear.
Once again, Edge spears Mick Foley.
Mick Foley never knows when to keep his nose out of it. And Mick Foley's got about 3 weeks left in his career as well.
Well, Edge was about to spear Maria. Thank God Mick Foley showed up, and now look at him.
Boom!
I'm going to tell you something. It's Edge and Lita.
Hey, Mick.
Don't.
Come on, you speared the man. That's enough.
It's never enough, King. It's never enough.
No.
Boom!
God,
what a concerto!
Oh, and Mick, about that challenge that you threw at me last week for a hardcore match at WrestleMania, I accept!
Resounding acceptance at that.
Man, we're going to show this again, but this is not for the weak of heart. This is horrific. Listen. Oh, my God. And concerto from Edge on Mick Foley.
Hey, Mick,
we need some help out here for Mick.
Mick Foley wanted an answer.
We need some help out here for Mick.
Edge accepted the challenge of Mick Foley. Mick Foley unconscious.
Yeah, Mick Foley hasn't moved yet.
Guys, we need some help. Edge is so proud of himself. Troy, have you ever heard of Shattered Dreams?
Yes, I have. I've actually seen that administered a time or two.
Well, we may be about to see it again.
This does not bode well for the Rated R Superstar.
Yeah, I guarantee you, we're going to see a lot of Shattered Dreams on Nashville Star this season.
Well, you'll have to tune in to see.
That's a different kind of Shattered Dream, though.
Hey, wait a minute. Lita's up on a ring.
It's still painful, no matter how you slice it.
Can somebody say, ho!
King.
What?
Stop. I know what you mean.
There's
the
spear!
Lita once again distracting the opponent of Edge. Two, three.
It only takes a second for the rated R superstar. I hope Mick Foley was watching this if he's able to. You know, after that concerto 1 week ago, I tell you what, I doubt Mick Foley is able to see straight yet.
Well, I'm sure Mick Foley will see his way to WrestleMania.
Well, he might get the side down. I don't know if he's going to leave it. Cowboy Troy, we appreciate it.
Hey, thanks a lot, guys.
Thanks,
I really
much.
Appreciate it.
And if you're, good luck at National Store. And if you're free on Mondays, we can get rid of it.
Hey, shut up, Joey.
Thanks, Ed.
Hey, Cowboy Carl. Whatever the hell your name
is. It's Cowboy Troy, brother.
You want to try and steal my thunder? I'm the star of this show. The Rated R Superstar.
Sounds like he needs to buy a vowel, brother.
And I'm going to be the star of WrestleMania. You want me to prove it? Roll the trailer.
From Edge, the acclaimed superstar who brought you TLC.
Oh my God! Edge for the 21 ladder!
And Money in the Bank.
Oh my God! This is done it! Edge has earned the opportunity to wrestle the world's champion.
Comes his greatest WrestleMania yet.
Mick Foley versus Edge.
On April 2nd, the most watched champion of the past 5 years returns to the scene of his greatest triumphs.
I've never lost at WrestleMania.
And this time, it's hardcore.
Oh, God, what a concerto!
Witness the final destruction of Mick Foley at WrestleMania 22.
Mick, you're pathetic!
Of the Rated R Superstar, Edge.
That was beautiful. Emotional, powerful.
You see, Mick, you're just gonna add to my WrestleMania legacy. And if you think otherwise, then you can tell me on Saturday night's main event.
What?
It's gonna be the return of my talk show, The Cutting Edge. And Mick, you will be the guest. The only difference is this Cutting Edge will be rated H for hardcore.
Oh man.
Well, I can't wait for that. Yeah. Saturday night's main event. Edge is gonna get, he's going to have the nerve to get face-to-face with Mick Foley and the Cutting Edge.
This Saturday night on NBC, apparently he is.
And that's one of the greatest shows ever in the history of the WWE.
What?
And Edge is on the Cutting Edge.
Oh, please.
And Edge is on the top of his game.
Right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here comes the Rated R Superstar. Edge here for the Cutting Edge. The special guest here at the part of WrestleMania, Mick Foley.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the host of The Cutting Edge, Edge.
Well, you know, it's just 2 weeks ago that Edge, he had a little encounter on Raw with none other than Mick Foley. And check this out. I think Edge was intent on ending Mick Foley's career. You can hear that all the way back in Long Island. Edge calls out the concerto. And Foley lying unconscious there. Edge and Lita. Ladies and gentlemen, Edge hosts his talk show, The Cutting Edge. His guest will be his opponent at WrestleMania, Mick Foley. And it's next. We are back on Saturday night's main event. Edge winning the arrival of Mick Foley.
Welcome to The Cutting Edge. Of the Rated R Superstar, the most watched champion in the past 5 years. Oh, and the man who is perfect at WrestleMania. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Edge.
getting a standing boo here.
Thank you, Lita. And I plan on remaining perfect at WrestleMania. When I beat my guest tonight, the supposed hardcore legend, Mick Foley. You might notice these hardcore weapons strewn about the ring. And I put them here to make Mick feel comfortable, to inspire him, so that when I beat him at WrestleMania, it actually means something. Because right now, it's not gonna mean much. You see, Mick Foley isn't the hardcore legend anymore.
The fans disagree.
For those of you just tuning in, Mick Foley has gone from being a hardcore legend to a cuddly teddy bear. A Muppet. His latest shtick is he'll come out here and say the name of this city to get a reaction from you idiots. Because let's face it, that's the only way he can get that reaction nowadays. Then he'll come out here and he'll plug his latest outside endeavor, which will fail miserably. And then he'll dance around the ring with a sock puppet on his hand. Oh, it's all very impressive, but it's not exactly cutting edge. So change your plans, Mick. I want you out here right now so I can give you your WrestleMania beatdown and put you out of your misery. Get it? Good. So ladies and gentlemen, I give to you, Mick Foley. Just like I thought, you never fail to disappoint, do you, Mick? Proving once again that you are the most overrated superstar in the history of this industry.
And then again, maybe not. Look at the expression on Mick. What the heck is Edge doing? Edge sprayed it. You smell that?
Yeah, I do. Whoa, this is not good. Wait a minute.
Edge wants to do more than talk here.
Hey,
Edge just set the table afire. Edge just set that table afire. Get that fire out.
Great.
Edge wants to do more than talk here. And Foley is tired of talking. Mick Foley went from Ward Cleaver to Meat Cleaver. Look, Cactus Jack's side. Mick Foley, the multifaceted Mick Foley.
Damn,
right in the face. Of Mick Foley coming out. This is not going to be one of those nice Katie Couric-like interviews.
No, I think Edge thought that he was going to intimidate Mick Foley at his own game. Wait a minute, what's in that bag?
We're not. Oh my gosh, that's Edge. What? Look at the thumbtacks. Hundreds of thumbtacks have been poured on the canvas here in the hardcore legend, multiple time best-selling author, Mick Foley. Is hammering Lita with a cheap shot. Thanks to Lita. Foley taken straight down into those thumbtacks.
Oh, man.
Lita saving Edge's backside yet another time. For someone that is, look at this, lost thumbtacks. And the smile. Foley had that demonic smile on his face like he liked it. How could you like it?
And over you, Edge and Lita.
The steel chairs meet, and Foley, neckbreaker on the steel. The neckbreaker of solid steel by Mrs. Foley's baby boy.
Foley with those thumbtacks still sticking in his.
Oh, no, wait a minute. Edge out of it here. Yes, Foley. Dropping Edge face first in that steel chair.
Oh, guys, I think I see what's coming, JR. I think Mick Foley wants to return that favor that Edge gave him with that concerto.
Foley.
No, don't do that!
Foley looking to eradicate Edge before WrestleMania. Oh, what a match. I think.
think we have seen a side that the old Mick Foley has been rejuvenated here somewhat, King.
I think we've seen a side that certainly Edge or Lita didn't want to see, not before WrestleMania.
And another look at the concerto. Look.
And listen. Wow.
Bang, bang is right. Will Foley be ready for WrestleMania? I suggest absolutely. And will you be ready for more of the Saturday Night's Main Event? We'll be right back.
Obviously, this crowd appreciated what they just saw from Saturday.
I've got just a few things I'd like to say to Edge. A few short words, Edge. Thank you. You see, I want to thank Edge because whether you like him or whether you hate him, Edge speaks the truth. He spoke the truth when he said that I was a cuddly teddy bear. A Muppet, I think he called me. He spoke the truth when he said I'd been coasting on my reputation. And unfortunately, Edge spoke the truth when he said I'd never had that one great WrestleMania moment. And the truth is, if it was a few short weeks ago, I would come out here, put my thumb in the air, say the name of your town, mention a book that nobody's going to read, and then prance around here with a sock puppet. But 2 weeks ago, after suffering from the one-man concerto, I lay awake in bed in my hotel room, tossing and turning, unable to sleep, partially because of the pain, but partially because I realized that Edge was absolutely right. But something seemed to change that night, because 2 nights ago, on Saturday night's main event, when I was thrown into the bed of tacks and tasted my own blood, like I'd done so many times throughout my career, I realized the blood was somehow different. Felt different, tasted different, was different. Because I realized it wasn't so much blood as it was Chinese food.
Chinese food?
Because only a few short hours after tasting it, I was thirsty for some more.
Oh.
But no, Edge. I wasn't thirsty for my own blood. I was thirsty for yours. You see, you've spoken the truth, but by doing so, you've awoken something inside of me that was sleeping for too long. Do you know what you've done? You have created a monster. You've brought back to life the hardcore legend. Someone, some of you might remember as Cactus Jack.
Oh yeah,
Edge, you spoke the truth. And at WrestleMania, you will find that the truth hurts. Baby!
There you go.
You think you know me?
Uh-oh. Now, here comes Edge.
Yeah, well, come on out here, Edge. Get you some of the...
Edge will stand idly by and listen to all this. Well, there's Lita. Edge is surely going to be right behind her. We've all heard enough from Mick Foley.
Wow. As he said, Coach, there's Lita, but no rated R superstar.
Or he's coming.
Where is it?
Lita, I wouldn't go in there anywhere near Foley right now. Look at Foley. He's looking around for Edge.
Not in the state of mind that he's in.
Watch your back. Watch your back, Mick.
Whoa, Mick. Settle down. Look, you guys, this is very important, and if you could please keep your comments to yourself. Y'all aren't getting any anyway, so you might as well shut up.
Oh.
Look. Mick, you've proved your point. We get it. You know, after giving Edge the concerto on Saturday night, Mick, he's still in Detroit. Edge can't even fly. He has like vertigo and stuff. It's bad, Mick. Which is why I need to speak to the old Mick Foley, please. The kind and caring and compassionate Mick Foley. No. Please, the Winnie the Pooh wearing sweatshirt, I love that. That Mick Foley, I'm very fond of him. I could please have that for just a second. If I could, from the bottom of your heart, if you could find it to just hear me out, please. Mick, please. Edge has a suggestion, okay? And I think it's great. He thinks the two of you should just call off this whole hardcore match at WrestleMania.
Oh, call it off.
You know, but Mick, he's got a better idea. The two of you, you go out there and you have a wrestling match.
That makes sense. A lot of
sense. You
know,
look, I know it's not your thing. I know that, but that's just the thing. This could be your WrestleMania moment, Mick. You know, all the critics. Excuse me. Mick, all those naysayers, all the critics that said that you're nothing more than a glorified stuntman, you go out there and you prove them wrong. And Mick, you know, you want to go out there and you make your kids proud. You show them that dad can wrestle without the thumbtacks, without the barbed wire. Just for one night. Just for one night. What do you say, Mick?
What do I say, you ask? What do I say? I said on Saturday night, Edge called me out on my stick. So now I'm gonna call him out on his. You see, every morning, Edge wakes up a little idea. He's gonna trot out his sweet, innocent little girlfriend. And then that sweet, innocent little girlfriend's going to distract me so that Edge can lower the boom from behind. Isn't that right, Lita? Isn't this about the time that you slap me, rile me up, so that Edge can take advantage of me? Come on, Lita, it's time you slap me. Slap, oh. You can do. Slap me, Lita, slap me.
Hey.
Slap me.
Foley's right, look at this.
Here comes Edge.
Here comes Edge.
Oh, look at this.
Mick Foley blocked the low blow.
Look at this.
He's got that mandible claw on Lita.
Question Edge's intestinal fortitude, King.
Oh, man. Oh, I hate to say it, but Mick Foley was ready for everything tonight. Nobody's going to question Mick Foley because we're seeing the old hardcore legend. The Mick Foley that thinks if you're not missing a body part, you're a sissy. I can't wait to WrestleMania.
I feel sorry for Lita. Mick's fingers were stuck down her throat.
Let's see that one more time.
Why didn't Edge do something about it? Here comes Edge.
A chance.
And look at this. Mick stopped the low blow and then he slapped the mandible claw on Lita, the mandible claw, and Edge just stood there and watched.
Absolutely nothing from Edge.
Whatever Edge has woken in Mick Foley, he's woken it at the wrong time. He's woken it right before WrestleMania.
In less than 2 weeks, Mick Foley and Edge will indeed meet in a hardcore matchup. What is Edge gonna do when Mick Foley breaks down his hardcore wrath on the Rated R Super?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mick
down to the ring. But last week we saw Mick Foley begging Lita to slap him, which he did. Mick Foley then from behind blocked the low blow, and then this is just inexplicable.
It's as great as what it is, and we see Edge showing his true colors. He was gutless. He wouldn't even get in the ring to save his own girl.
Hey, King. What? Edge is too smart for Mick Foley's tricks. He's going to wait for WrestleMania. Don't you get that? This crowd's ready for WrestleMania.
Next Sunday, I will fight Edge at a hardcore match at WrestleMania. But that does not give me the right to take his sweet, innocent little girlfriend and shove my fingers down her throat. That was wrong. And in order to make it up to Lita, well, I brought her these. But don't think I've forgotten about you, Edge. You see, there's a gift for you right up there on the stage. So unless last week was a fluke and you've suffered from a complete lack of intestinal fortitude, why don't you and Lita come walking out here and accept my humble gifts?
It's quite the invitation, guys.
You think you know me?
One that's about to be accepted.
Certainly seem that way.
I wonder what's in the box, though.
Cut the music! Cut it! Cut the music! Foley, last week you caught me off guard, but that's not gonna happen again. When it comes to your present, why the hell should we open that? How do we know it's not a trap? You don't know, Edge! You don't know, but trust me, at WrestleMania, it will be something you can use.
Well, something I can use, right? Well, I know what you can use, Mick. You could use a win at WrestleMania. But it's not gonna happen this Sunday. No, you see, your legacy, Mick, has become like a giant ATM account. The only thing you're gonna collect at WrestleMania. Mick, the only thing you're gonna collect at WrestleMania is what's most important to you nowadays. A paycheck.
Unfortunately, that's very, very true.
You see, you keep coming back to Raw and dipping into your account and dipping into it and dipping into it until there's not gonna be anything left. Well, you're not gonna pad your legacy on my account. In case you forgot, you cost me the WWE title. I should be in the main event at WrestleMania this Sunday.
Wait. You see, you've got it all wrong, Edge. It's not about the money. It's about that defining WrestleMania moment, and I've got one right up here in my head. It's about you, Edge. It's about you bleeding badly from various parts of your body. It's about you, Edge, begging me for mercy, except I can't hear. Because many years ago, in a land far away in a hardcore match, I had my ear ripped off my head. Oh. But don't worry, Edge. I'm not going to rip your ear off your head because I want you to hear everything. I want you to hear the sick sound of your flesh tearing when I carve you up. I want to hear the sound of the children screaming, their little lives psychologically scarred forever. I want you to hear the little pitter patter of blood drops hitting canvas as they rain down from your skull. And most of all, Edge, I want you to hear that ring announcer when they say the winner of this match at WrestleMania is Mick Foley. You see, that's why I brought out the present, to give you a fighting chance. So why don't you look in there, open up the box, Edge. Open up the box.
You arrogant son of a bitch. You want to give this to me as a gift for WrestleMania? Well, tonight, I'm going to give you a gift that keeps on giving.
Uh-oh. Edge and Mick Foley may not wait until this Sunday at WrestleMania.
What is Foley thinking, giving Edge a baseball bat? Foley's got his own bat, but it's covered in the bar. Yeah.
My gosh. Look at Mick Foley. I can tell you as a veteran that you never lose the ability to reach down and find what's inside. And I think Foley has found it for WrestleMania.
Well, King, he's going to have to find it spiritually, mentally, and emotionally. Because if Mick Foley doesn't do that, he's going to get destroyed by Edge at WrestleMania.
Look,